I can't hear.
Fueling dreams. The allegiance to fortifying science and technology. The institution that has been the foundation of many dreams. Venture Center.
The vision of Venture Center is to create a world-class cluster of inventive enterprises, science-based startups and knowledge-based companies for India in the next 10 years.
Ideas require a world of support when they move from concept to reality. Located in the beautiful campus of the NCL Innovation Park, the Venture Center is spread over a massive 12 acres. This facility has been home to over 200 entrepreneurs and over 75 startups with inventive products since its inception in January 2007. Our aim is to nucleate and nurture technology and knowledge-based enterprises.
Any entrepreneurship begins with certain basics. First basic thing is that the vision and the motivation and the excitement. The other thing along with it is the risk-taking ability. But overall, if you have a look at it, it needs a very good support, not only in terms of finance, in terms of management, in terms of networking, in terms of overall mentoring. That is what we call it an innovation center, wherein you can manage the innovation, then you can define what could be the obstacles in taking these innovations forward and accordingly fill in the gaps by providing the requisite supports. As I said, based around these three pillars of capital, management and the technology.
The Venture Center was initiated with the aim of filling the vital gap in the startup ecosystem and hence has focused on providing a nurturing environment to the startups through various incubation programs. Presently, the Venture Center hosts startups working in areas as diverse as materials, chemicals, biological sciences, and engineering.
Journey of an entrepreneur in Venture Center begins through a proof of concept stage where you take the idea from a concept to a proof of that concept and then validate it through various stages and eventually get it to a point where there is a product which one can actually demonstrate to somebody, a prototype or a product. And to make this happen, you need to have an ecosystem that supports it. We have created, for example, infrastructural facilities which support that. We have created mentors, we have brought in mentors and advisors to come and talk to some of these startups. The journey of an entrepreneur in Venture Center ends roughly at the point where they have raised adequate resources to fly out of this incubator.
Venture Center provides the ecosystem that is needed from a startup standpoint.
This place is very helpful in terms of exposing you to the unseen dimensions of business of science basically.
So in a neonatal intensive care unit, you will see a incubator as one of the most useful and life-saving equipments, which nourishes a newborn from the time of birth to a stage that it can go on in the world and grow further. Venture Center has been the same incubator for me if I were replaced by that newborn. And when I think of Venture Center, I have a sense of gratitude and confidence.
Venture Center is actually a launching pad for budding entrepreneurs and startups who has got a vision and a mission and a passion.
At the Venture Center, we fulfill your incubation requirements. Our offerings span across dedicated, ready-to-use, dry and wet laboratory spaces, specialized and regular shared scientific facilities like biology and health sciences, analytical and instrumentation, prototyping, soft materials and chemistry lab, mass spectrometry and tinkering lab to support prototype development. We also offer ready-to-move in office spaces and plug-and-play desk spaces. Venture Center has built physical resources center, which are also accessible to the public.
people from like Cambridge or Silicon Valley or Boston. You name the place and experts from those locations come here for talks and guidance on a regular basis.
So Venture Center has done an amazing job of bringing in those right people, exposing us to those talks, giving us an opportunity to interact with these people, understanding what it means to start a business, to grow it and develop it into a culture.
It's not just the great facilities that you have here, but the mentoring that you receive on every front is just world class.
We work rigorously towards providing referrals and mentors, funding opportunities, business networking opportunities and investors network that are key to turning the innovative ideas into revolutionary products. Our advisory programs such as Ignition Program, Kickstart Program, Associate Incubatory Program are designed to fulfill the mentoring requirements of the startups at various stages of their ventures.
When it comes to productizing our own science, I think Venture Center helps us in fulfilling all the requirements wherein we scientists, we do not know.
Team over here is extremely passionate. They are in tune with the nature of the startup entrepreneur's mindset. They understand that and basically they're helping us all throughout the way.
The Venture Center has partnered with various government projects that provide funding for early startups. These include BIG, SIIP, SEED support system and proof of concept fund.
So some of the most important parts are there are a lot of grants that are, as I said, are available from Department of Science and Technology and Government of India and different departments. So Venture Center is a conduit for that. So, and one of the most important parts is from a grant standpoint, they do a lot of mentoring in terms of what is most important, how, because there might be innovation in your products, but they basically help you navigate in terms of what the Department of Science and Technology is looking at.
There were bad times when we did not have any sort of financial support. It was a motivational and an emotional connect as well with Venture Center.
We didn't have external funding, so Venture Center provided us space on some of by one of their schemes, wherein we were able to get a lab and some equipment funding, which we used to develop an initial prototype. Now, using that initial prototype and that small funding, we were able to raise large venture capital funding as well as the government funding.
Our commitment to science and technology and to a better tomorrow is our constant source of inspiration.
The Venture Center would like to tell all budding entrepreneurs that if you're pursuing ideas for which will solve the greatest problems of tomorrow, and if you wish to build companies which will shape India's economy and the future, then Venture Center is here to help you. And this is the place where you would like to begin your journey of creating those companies.
Let me share my screen now. Yeah. Is the screen visible to all?
It's not yet.
Not yet, ma'am.
Okay. I'll share it again. Is it visible now?
Yes.
Okay. Thanks for playing that video. I hope with that video, everyone has got a good glimpse and a good idea of what Venture Center is doing for budding entrepreneurs. So today I'm here to talk in detail about a biotechnology ignition grant, which is a grant by BIRAC DBT, and that call is right now open from 1st of January to 15th of February. So I would like to share more details about this grant, you know. So people who are right now ready with an innovative idea and say proof of concept for that idea can apply for this particular call. And suppose if you are not yet ready, you might, you know, get to know the details and prepare yourself. So this call opens twice a year and you might wish to apply for the next call, that is BIG 19, that will be in July, that will open in July. Okay. So thank you for the introduction and invitation. So let's get started. So this BIG call is the 18th call, which is now open. And so here you can see the poster, which is there. And till date, the BIG has supported more than 550 ideas across the country. And we will talk more in detail about this particular grant. So Ministry of Science and Technology, so there are two departments, Department of Science and Technology and Department of Biotechnology, and Venture Center is closely working with both DBT and DST, and we are implementation partners of a lot of their funding programs. So Department of Biotechnology has an arm called as BIRAC, that's Biotechnology Industry Research Assistance Council. So, you know, which has a lot of initiatives to support commercialization of all these innovative projects. So one of the initiative is Biotechnology Ignition Grant. So the main aim and objective of this particular grant is to promote or foster generation of ideas which have a commercialization potential, okay, which can reach the market to the customers, to the society. So it supports innovative ideas to establish proof of concept. So even if you are at idea stage, you can think of applying for this grant, but we always suggest that it's better if you have some proof of concept and you may validate it more with the help of this grant. So it will help you in upscaling and validating the proof of concept, your POC. So it encourages the researchers to take technology closer to market through a startup. So you will have to incorporate a company or startup and take it ahead once you are through, you get selected. So this particular grant or the objective is to stimulate enterprise formation, as I said, company formation. So yes, so the highlights are in BIG, we provide funding to startups as well as individuals. Okay, so we'll come later to the eligibility for startups and individuals. So it's a funding in the form of grant in aid. So we say it's a grant funding. So in here, what is expected in return from the grantee, if you get this grant, you are expected to complete the work which you have proposed in your proposal as milestones. So say first 6 months, if you propose, I will complete this much work, these experiments, and then next 6 months, I will work on these experiments. Next 6 months, maybe I'll file the patent or whatever is proposed. So over a period of 18 months, you will be submitting a plan. And after every 6 months, there'll be a committee which will monitor the progress, what work you have done. And based on the progress, they will release the next tranche of money of the grant. So that's how it progresses, and it's a grant in aid. So you're not expected, any royalty there. But having said that, from BIG 16, the royalty clause has been added by BIRAC, but till now, like, they have not asked anyone for that actually. So maybe if you really make it, make it to success and you get good commercialization happens, then maybe they would ask, but till now they have not asked any of the companies. So what you get from the BIG partners, so as Venture Center, we are one of the BIG partners, and I'll show you one more slide where we'll see who all are the BIG partners, the different incubation centers. So from these BIG partners, you will get mentoring, advisory support for the grant application. And if you are selected, then further mentoring for your presentation So there are a lot of benefits from this BIG grant. You get to learn a lot throughout this process. You get to network with people, get to know people. There's a lot of visibility. You'll be covered in all the programs. You will get to attend a lot of events which are organized by BIG partners, BIRAC, you know, not only in India, but abroad too. And that's how, and also your ideas get evaluated. So if you feel that, you know, why should I apply? I am not very confident. You can still try to apply, because once you have applied, there will be a few reviewers who will review the application, and you will get to know their comments, what they have, you know, found in your project, what is lacking, what are the strengths, where can you work more, and how can you improve it better. So that's also one of the advantages. So what is the BIG scope? What all is covered under BIG and what is not covered? So BIG supports technology objectives. So you have to have a POC, and you, if you want to establish or validate that POC mode, if you want to do more experiments to do the technology de-risking. So here, when we talk of science and technology products, you know, we know that there's a lot of risk involved, especially when it is pharma, drug development and all. There is risk that we are not sure whether it will be successful. It can even fail in phase 3 clinical trials, right? So when we perform a lot of experiments and we have the data with us, that data helps us in being confident about the project. So that's called technology de-risking. So that can be done. Scientific data to demonstrate idea to licensors or investors. So you may actually work on a technology and think of licensing it to a bigger manufacturer or a company, you know. You might not yourself take it to the last end thing of marketing and business development and selling it. So you need to demonstrate some scientific data. For those experiments, you can apply for BIG. Translation of ideas into commercially viable products or technologies to address unmet need. Yes, so we will come to unmet need later. So this is all about translating ideas. So you may have ideas, you may have done some preliminary studies on it, but whether it is commercially feasible, viable, when you say about viability, it is also talking about financial viability, that whether as a business, you will be able to make profit or not. So whether there is a desire for this kind of product in the market or not, so all that will be there. Now, what is not supported by BIG is exploratory research. Any kind of basic research would not be supported. Applied research is supported by BIG. If it is just a PhD work or a master's project work, it will not be supported. If there is no plan for further, you know, commercializing that particular process or product or service, then it will not be supported. Obviously, if it is not novel, if there is no unmet need, it won't be supported. If there are a lot of EHS risk, environment, health and safety risk, or if it is non-ethical, there are some issues, then it won't be supported. As we mentioned here, if there is no commercialization potential further, it won't be supported. And this, yes, this applies to pharma audience here. So, you know, this is a 50 lakh grant over a period of 18 months. So whenever we are proposing anything, we have to make sure that whatever activities we are proposing can be done in that budget of 50 lakhs in the 18 months period. So we all know that clinical trials would require more money. Okay, they are very expensive. So we can't say that we have this drug, we have done, say, in silico studies and some in vitro studies. And with BIG now, I will do the preclinical also and say phase one also, phase two also. So the reviewer will clearly say that, see, this is all not possible. You can say that I'll do some of the in vitro and maybe preclinical with 50 lakhs, that's okay. But you can't, you know, put in everything, right? From end to end, product development will happen through BIG. No. So BIG can support a part of the development work, which is actually feasible, possible with 50 lakhs and in the 18 months period. So you have to be very careful while writing the grant application that you are, you know, these two points are taken care of. So what are the broad domains which are allowed for BIG proposal? So here you can see healthcare and medical biotech, agriculture, industrial biotechnology, food security, so industrial product and processes, bio-IT. And in the latest slide here, yeah. So there, from last few calls, there have been themes and sub-themes. So these are the broader themes here, and then the sub-themes under these themes. So the first theme here is healthcare, devices, diagnostics, and drugs. Then there is a theme on industrial biotechnology, industrial products and processes, and agriculture and allied areas. So energy, environment, and all would come under this. So under healthcare, then comes medical devices, diagnostics, and drugs. So you can, you would be developing some kind of devices, implants, you know, those will be under this. Any diagnostic kits, point of care diagnostics, or different kind of diagnostics would be here. Drugs can be of different types. It can be a vaccine, a drug delivery system, biosimilars, phytopharma, stem cells. Okay. Regenerative medicines, actually biosimilars and stem cells would come under this also, and drugs also. If industrial biotechnology, if you're working on any processes also of recombinant technology, or then there are other areas like bioenergy, biofuels, clean energy, waste management, sanitation, all that would come under industrial biotechnology if there is some interface of you know, any bioprocess there. Agriculture, all these different domains, right from poultry, aqua, animal husbandry, food processing also is an area, biopesticides, biofertilizers, all that would come under agriculture. And again, here at the end, you can see big data, data analytics, artificial intelligence, machine learning, Internet of Things, automation. So all this, if there is a bio interface to that, okay? So using this, if you are trying to develop any of these, then also you can apply. So coming to the eligibility criteria for applying for this grant, so you can apply as a startup or an individual, okay? So if you are a startup, you have to have at least 51% of the shareholding should be by a Indian citizen, resident Indian citizen. And you will be considered under this category if your company is not more than 5 years old, okay? So right from the date of registration, if it is not more than 5 years old, you can apply for BIG. So company should have either a functional R&D, means you should have your own lab, or else you will state in the proposal that you need to select a BIG partner, an incubator, and you will work with them. And you need to have a committed project leader. This is not something which is a part-time. It is a full-time thing. And you have to show who will be the person, if selected, would handle this project, would be the project leader, and will be responsible for all the activities, right from signing the agreement to, you know, completing the project and doing everything. If you are an individual as a researcher, if you want to apply, you have to be an Indian citizen. Since you are an individual, there won't be any company. So you have to get incubated at a technology business incubator like ours. You should have at least completed basic graduation, 4 years of your graduation or 3 years of your graduation. You have to do it as a full-time project. That's it. So if it's a faculty, then I'll tell you what is to be done. So individual can be a faculty or a student or any researcher. So now we'll tell you that we heard in the earlier slides and in the video also, you saw that we are a technology business incubator. And if you have to apply for BIG, you have to, you know, do it through a BIG partner. So those BIG partners are different technology business incubators in the country. So what is an incubator? So we all know that as Nishant mentioned in the video, that there is an NICU and there is an incubator there, which you can imagine where you keep the babies. So what is the purpose of that incubator is it makes sure that there is controlled and protected environment provided to that baby, you know, so that it survives. Similarly, an incubator like us makes sure that we provide a good ecosystem environment, which helps the startup to sustain this journey of entrepreneurship. So we provide them dedicated physical facilities, you know, to startups as well as individuals. So there are all these scientific facilities, mentoring and advisory support, which we provide. And so if I have to tell you about those different services which we provide at Venture Center, so our USP is advisory and mentoring. So we run something called as an Ignition program, which is a pre-incubation program. So in the Ignition program, it's a 5 hours program per year, which you can enroll for. And we make sure we give you training for IP, regulatory, grant writing, financials, basics, and funding opportunities. All this is discussed in that. Scientific facilities, we have all high-end analytical equipment. We have a tinkering lab, which has a 3D printer, laser cutter, and all these facilities which are required for prototyping. Then we have even shared labs. So as an individual, if you don't have a research lab to work in, you can walk in those shared labs, which are shared chemistry lab, shared analysis lab, and shared bio lab, which have the basic equipment required for doing research. So this incubator, you need to have a formal approval from an incubator. So we give something called as a letter of intent to BIG applicant. Okay. So applicants from research and academic organizations cannot claim their own research labs as incubation space. Means if you are a faculty or student, you can't say that you will work in your college lab, and that is not allowed. So as I said, a LOI or MOU from the incubator is required for the final approval, and your chosen incubator may or may not be your BIG partner. That is, suppose if you, while applying for BIG, you select Venture Center as the BIG partner, okay? So we will help you. We will start with mentoring sessions with you. We will evaluate your proposal, how you have put down the things in the proposal. If we feel that there is need for modification, we'll definitely tell you what areas needs to be modified, how it can be written in a proper manner. Okay? And once that is done, you submit the application. After that, there will be an initial review. And if you are selected for the further round for presentation, then we'll sit with you and we will work on your slides. We'll make sure that, you know, they actually give hardly 5 to 6 minutes for you to present the whole thing. So we make sure that all the critical things are highlighted and covered in your presentation and how it has to be delivered to. So that all help we provide you. So after that, if you are selected and you get the grant, so it's not necessary that you have to continue with us only as incubator partner. If you are suppose based in Bangalore, so you may select a BIG partner for Bangalore. You can select an incubator that I want to work in Bangalore and not at Venture Center in Pune. So that's also okay with us. So as I said, I'll tell you about BIG partners. So these are the different BIG partners. These are all technology business incubators. So CCAMP in Bangalore, FITT in Delhi, IIT, Hyderabad, IKP is there, Bhuneshwar, KIT, TBI is there. We are there in Pune. Kanpur, it's there. Hyderabad, IDEA NAM focuses more on agriculture sector. And then in Mumbai, IIT Bombay, SCIEN is there. And then there are BIG associate partners also who help in awareness programs. So yeah, coming to some tips and pointers to apply for BIG. So as I said earlier, that IDEA stage also can apply, but we insist that it is better that you have a proof of concept. So I hope the students understand the difference here, that idea is when you have only thought of something, you know what is the problem. Say cancer is a problem. Okay. So you know that maybe you need to come up with some anti-cancer drugs, or the drug is already there. Maybe you are working on a formulation. So the idea is there in your mind that if I develop it in this way, it will have better efficacy or safety profile, and it would be useful for the patients. So that can be your idea. So what is proof of concept is when you actually maybe synthesize it or formulate it, and you do some in vitro tests which give you more confidence that you had assumed, you had hypothesized that this is the way it will act, and I'll have say 95% efficacy. So if at least with one experiment you are able to prove that it is giving that 95% efficacy, then you say that you had a concept And now you have a proof of concept. Okay. So that adds credentials to your application. Next is novelty in the proposed work. So you have to identify what is the unmet need which you are trying to address and how novel your solution is. Okay. That has to be very well written in the application. Technical feasibility and doability. Yes, you must, you know, it shouldn't be that you are proposing something, but as an expert from that field, I shouldn't feel that, you know, this would just be a publication and it is not a feasible thing, or technically also it is not feasible. That shouldn't happen. So if it's suppose synthesis and you are proposing some kind of reactions which are very difficult and might be say possible at lab scale, but at a little higher scale at pilot or plant scale, those are not feasible. So those will not work. Any IP barriers. So you must do a prior art search and check for freedom to operate. So freedom to operate in the sense, we all know that any innovation would be protected by patents or any form of intellectual property. So if whatever you're thinking of is already, you know, reported there, it's there in the public domain. If someone already has a patent and you are working on the same thing, then later those people can sue you. Yeah, there can be patent infringement. So you make sure that you do a prior art search. You can even take help of our intellectual property facilitation center and make sure that whatever claims you are making, those are new and not reported. So that's the area of freedom to operate for you. Clarity of business model. So you should be clear that whether you're working on a process or a product, or you will be offering a services. So what you will be offering, and around that you have to build your business model. Okay. So business model, and then you have to have what is the market size? Who are your target customers? All that should be captured in the application. Clear indication of PI's commitment to commercialization. So PI is the project investigator or the project leader. So there should be a clear commitment from the PI, and we'll come to the team part of it later again. A credible and complete team. So I'll tell you what does that mean. Goals, proof of concept, achievable in 18 months. So as I said, it should be feasible, doable, something which is really achievable in 18 months with 50 lakh with the proposed budget. So you should try to include only that in the application. So as Venture Center, we recommend that there should be a clear proof of concept definition there. Okay. You must highlight the novelty and importance of this particular product or process. Take efforts in writing the concept note. So we'll come to the different parts of the proposal. There is something called as a concept note, which you have to write. So make sure all these pointers which we discussed, you know, you highlight all those in your concept note. You must state somewhere that what is your plan for IP generation, whether you already have a patent or you plan to file a patent later, and what are the possibilities. That should be captured in the application. Clear plan of work in stages. So you will be asked to prepare a work plan. So month-wise activities you will have to define. So that should be clearly done. Constitution of the team is very important. It shouldn't be that, you know, you are as a one person individual, you are applying and you apply as an individual. So there are very less chances you will get through. It's always a team, you know. So the team, how will you constitute the team? So if you are the technical expert from that field and it's actually your idea. So true, you may not be, you know, able to, willing to share it with a lot of people right now. But you should have other people also in the team, because it's not only the technical work which you will be doing as BIG. You will also need, if you have to form a company, you will need someone who understands finances, someone from CS or CA background. You might need someone who has prior experience of entrepreneurship, maybe as an advisor. You may need some more advisors from your own technical field. Or if you are working on some of the drugs, you may need to collaborate with some of the doctors for some advisory or experts from the field. So you make sure that right kind of representation is there from, you know, each kind of experts in your team. So that is what we look for in a team. So never apply as a single person. divide whole study into milestones. So as I said, this is a grant in aid. So you will be evaluated, say, after every 6 months, and you will define some milestones in your project. So you will say that, say, these number of experiments or this kind of work would be done in first 6 months. So that would be your milestone one. And based on the completion and satisfaction, you will get the next grant. Okay, the next amount will be released at that time. So coming to the budget part of it, because you'll have to include this in your application. So there are some caps for some of the heads. So you need to understand that. So the capex, you can exceed 30%, and anyone whom you're showing as a mentor or advisor, you can't pay them through the BIG project. Okay. So these are the different heads you need to plan. So equipment maximum, you can say 30% of the 50 lakh I would utilize for equipment. Consumables, it is little flexible. Maximum 30% for manpower. So yes, you can hire people once you get selected to do the work. So that can be, you know, incorporated here. Incubation, it's flexible. If you already have a company, you may not choose for incubation. But if you are an individual, you might like to first check with us how much would be the rent for 18 months for a particular lab, and that you can include in your budget. Travel, you might need to travel, you might need to file a patent or any IP, that you can incorporate here. And anything you want to outsource, some of the services which you are not able to do at your facility, that can be done, and some contingency can be shown here. So coming to the most important point is evaluation. So when we evaluate any project which is there for BIG, so this is how the weightages are. So the highest weightage here is for technical viability and the team. Okay. So though it has shown 15 here, but actually while reviewing, the reviewers first look at the team here, and I'll tell you what for they look here. So unmet need and novelty. So while you are stating what problem you are trying to solve how different your solution is, so you have to cover all these points. So what is the particular component which is making it novel? How it is different from the competitors who are already there in the market? And what will actually say that it is novel if it is supported by intellectual property protection? So if you already have a patent, or you say that there is potential for filing patents in India or any other country, so that would, you know, create more confidence about the novelty. Value proposition or differentiation is again about, see, your idea may not be the first there. There would be people with already that idea and products in the market. So how it is different? What are the different features of your process or technology which make it different from others, and how better it is, that you need to capture in this particular segment. Technical viability. In technical viability, you need to mention the feasible, whether the current state of knowledge, how it is feasible. If you have some preliminary data with you, okay, so that this particular idea we have tested, and this is what data we have got, which supports our assumptions, and now we would like to go ahead and test it more. So the technical claim should be really reasonable and supported by some preliminary studies. So they will be asking you, have you performed any preliminary studies? If yes, what was the data or data looks like, that you need to include. Team strength and passion. Now, this is the most important part. So they will definitely check the credentials of the project leader, what kind of work the person has done before, what experience they have, from which institution they come, what publications you have to your credit, whether you have, you know, worked on these kind of projects earlier. So basically they will make sure that, suppose you are from chemistry background and you have publications, say, all on, say, anti-cancer, anti-inflammatory drugs and all this and all, and not a single paper on formulation, suppose. It's all on synthesis, evaluation and designing the drug. And suddenly, if you propose in BIG that I will be working on, say, one of the formulation development, and they will check, you know, there are ways to check your background, and they will check that this person has never worked on this kind of thing. So how come suddenly they have decided to jump into this new area? So that disconnection should not be there. And again, the different team members, what is their expertise? What is their educational background, experience? So they will check for all this. So make sure that whatever project you are proposing and the different kind of expertise which are required, technical as well as business expertise, are part of your team. Okay. So they ask you to prepare a biodata, and that has to be submitted along with the application. So make sure that that biodata looks really rich. Business perspective, yes. So what is your go-to-market strategy? Whether you have done this study or not, evaluated that who will be my customer, which market segment this product or process will enter into or service I'll be offering to, what is the commercialization potential? So if this homework has not been done, so this you might lose over here. Then there would be like strategies to overcome few of the challenges that they would be asking, and a plan, the different project timelines and deliverables like milestones they'll ask you. Now, once all this is done, you are ready with the application, you will go for the application process. So you need to log in, you need to create your login on the BIRAC website, you need to register. And once you have registered, created the login, it is an online submission. So you need to have all these details there with you. So you first only prepare all these files and keep them ready so that you can directly upload them or fill the data wherever required. So as I said, first step is registration. So you need to log in to the BIRAC website, click to register for BIG scheme. A login password will be generated. Then there'll be questions like whether you are applying as a company or you are applying as an individual. So some basic information you should know for proposal submission. So you will prepare some basic information there. They'll ask you what is the title. So applicant type we have already discussed. You should have a very good title, which, you know, actually summarizes and highlights about the process or product you're working on. The duration they'll ask, the area from those thematic areas which I showed you, you have to select the one which is relevant to your project. Who will be your BIG partner? They'll ask you if you have applied earlier for BIG. Then brief background. So there are some documents which are to be attached there. So if it's a company, then you need the CIN, PAN and all these documents. Whether you have a facility or if you're working on any other BIRAC grant. If you are an individual, then your PAN, passport. If you're a faculty member, you would need an NOC. If you are a research student, you might need NOC. Okay. You will have to get one LOI from the incubator where you propose to do your work. That's it. Any other BIRAC grant if you're already working on. So for team details or project leader details, you will have to have all these details and the resume ready in the format which is there on the website. You can also have some scientific advisors or mentors in your team, and you can mention their details also. The proposal details, there will be a concept note which is actually a summary of your proposal. So make sure all these points which we discussed, the novelty, differentiation, value proposition, IP, plan to go to market, all that is captured in your summary. So it's all there in your summary, because summary is the first thing any reviewer will read. Then you move on to the next sections, objectives and proposed approach. What is the novelty, opportunity, challenges, what preliminary work you have done, that data has to be here. Proposed outcome, whether it will be a product, service or technology. Here just you have to select one word among these three. What is your plan of commercialization, go-to-market strategy, intellectual property already owned, or if you have done some prior art search, what is the freedom to operate, the references, any declarations, so if it is some clinical toxicology work, their ethical committee, if required, whether all that has been done or later you propose to do, you need to mention over here. Any regulatory guidelines you need to follow, you need to mention here. So in proposal, objective and work plan, you will have to make a tabular format is already there, where you write what will be the objective of that 6 months work. Suppose, say first 1 month, what you will do, what will be the objective, what methods you will use, what will be the experiments done. If those are not available, what would be the alternate strategy? Then activities to be undertaken by the company. So you will give month of starting, month of ending. So like a Gantt chart, which we do, and different indicators of progress. Sorry. Yeah. So there'll be milestones after each 6 months. Budget justification, equipment, HR, consumables. You should have that split up ready with you. And any other financial details if required. And also a presentation. So there is a presentation template which is available, which the BIG partner will share with you. And that presentation also you can upload along with the application. So now this is the whole BIG process in short here. So the call gets announced, as I told you, call gets announced twice a year. So now it is open till 15th Feb. Again, it will open on 1st of July and will be open till 15th of August. Then what happens is once you apply, eligibility check happens, then preliminary screening committee reviews your application. Okay, so there is an online review which happens. So if you clear all these steps and you move ahead, then there will be a technical expert panel who will be evaluating. So there you will have to present your project, and there will be a committee sitting there, and they will evaluate. And if you score more than 60 in that presentation round there, then you move ahead. And pre-COVID, these presentations used to happen in Delhi. So the thematic ones used to happen at incubators like Venture Center, and the ESC, the Expert Scientific Committee meeting, those used to happen at BIRAC at Delhi. But now in these pandemic conditions, everything is happening online. So if you are selected here, you move on to this ESC, and ESC, there'll be some cutoff for each themes. And if you clear this also, then you get selected for BIG. Once you get selected, your BIG partner will be asked to do due diligence. That is, if you are a company and you have stated in your proposal that you have all kind of facility equipment there with you to complete that project. So we will physically visit your facility and audit it, whether all those facilities are there and everything is there in place for you to actually implement the project, execute it. And if you directly get associated with incubators, then this is not required. So these are the timelines here. So the call gets announced, as you you know, approach us, we check for your eligibility, you apply, a preliminary screening happens. So say within 2 months period, say 1.5 months, you actually submit it. After that, within a month or so, you get to know whether you are selected for the next round. And so total, this period takes say around 120 to 140 days. And once you have been selected, the due diligence and release of funds would happen in the next 2 months. So you can see almost 6 months process it is. So if you start applying for this call, by the time the next call gets announced, maybe you get to know whether you have been selected or not, so that you know whether to apply for the next call or not. So now talking about Venture Center as a BIG partner and our success rate till now. So we have been associated with BIG from the call 4. And this time it is 18th call, and last call was the 17th call. So for 17th call, like you can see over here, the total applications which were received for BIG were 885. Out of these 885, Venture Center had received 86 applications. Out of those, 72 have been shortlisted. And now the TEP round, that is the presentation round, would start in first week of February. So almost 475 reviewers were engaged to review these 86 applications. So it is not one reviewer who reviews your application. At least 3 or 5 reviewers review the application. And it's all blinded. And we make sure that there is no conflict of interest when the reviewer is assigned for evaluating a particular project. So this is our BIG core team. Kirti handles the grant management of BIG and the mentoring. is done by all in-house mentors at Venture Center, Dr. Premnath and our incubation team and Kirti. And then comes the management part of it. So once you get the grant, then, you know, the disbursement of funds and managing it and monitoring it. So that's all about the information for BIG. So we are there on social media, on Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram. So I would tell all the students and faculty here, kindly get connected with us over social media on any of these platforms. So that would help you to stay updated and notified with all our current announcements for different funding calls which are open or the different events which we are running. Yeah, that's all from my side, but I would be happy to take questions and tell you more about Venture Center and different you know, services, or if you are if you have any other kind of questions also.
Thank you very much, ma'am. It's a really informative sessions. We learn a lot about Big Grant and Venture Center. So I request all the participants, if they have any questions, they can post in chat box.
So not only about BIG grant, but any other fellowships or services or how to get started with entrepreneurship, any kind of questions, you can connect to us.
Dr. Kale, I have one question, actually a couple of questions. As an applicant, there are two options, right? So as a company, and the second one is as an individual.
Yes.
So in the slides which you have shared, Wahapi, under the company, there was one term that is private organization. So are the colleges, the institutes are considered as those private organizations or private colleges, or no?
No, only it's maybe a R&D organization or companies.
Okay, and how about the academic institutes in that case? Like,
so the faculty member who's an innovator can apply, and you have to get an NOC from the college, okay? That, you know, they have no objection you applying for this grant, and they are well aware that if you get selected, then you may have to pursue this further for commercialization. And so sometimes there is an arrangement that some academic institutes allow their faculty to take, you know, a lien or some kind of leave they give for that particular period so they can pursue it. Or some arrangement like, say, in a week, 2 to 3 days, you can work at, say, that particular lab for that particular project. Or if it is not at all possible, the faculty member can appoint someone as the CEO of that company who will do it. And they can just provide the guidance and mentoring. The technical help can be provided.
Okay, so fine. So here in the budget part, there was one section about the instruments, equipments, basically.
Yeah.
So those equipments will be, if I apply as an individual through Venture Center or through the incubator.
Yeah.
So in that case, I have to first check with the incubator. Like in this case, I have to check with the Venture Center first that whatever instruments or equipments I am needing, whether they are present or not. And if not, then I have to put it in the budget, right?
Yes, correct.
Okay. Yes. And then later on, once the project, suppose it gets through, and if the, whenever the project gets complete, then what, who will be the, not owner, but who will be like getting that equipment, like whether the institute or whether the incubator?
No. See, once you get through, if you get selected, you will incorporate a company, okay? A private limited company. So whatever assets, you know, you are generating will be with the company only. Neither BIRAC nor the incubator will take it away. It's your company's assets.
I think, and one more question I had about that CapEx. You have mentioned somewhere CapEx. Because of some network issue, I wasn't able to hear that properly. What is it?
So CapEx is all your assets, like equipment and all.
Okay.
So that
okay.
cannot be more than 30%.
Okay. So it is basically the equipment part.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, my questions are clear. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah, I can see one question in the chat box. Sushil is asking, in case there is lack of fund during actual work, is there any provision to get funds? Can Venture Center will help during application? So first, I'll take up the second part of your question, that yes, Venture Center, just a minute. Sorry for that. Yeah. So yes, Venture Center will help during application. So you just have to drop an email to us that you are applying and you need some mentoring or advices from us, and we'll be happy to do that. And in case there is lack of fund, so we understand that, you know, if you have an idea and you think of entrepreneurship, so it will always not happen that you will be from a, you know, rich family and you will have all the funds ready with you to invest in that particular idea. That never happens. So if there is lack of fund, we will definitely suggest which are the best funding options for you, for which you can apply. We will help you in application. And in-house also, we have some CSR funds, some fellowship programs for early stage startups or entrepreneurs. And at little later stage, we have seed fundings with us. So like Dr. Shivani mentioned, if we get BIG and 18 months are over, what we do after that? So after that, you can apply for, there are different funds at different stages. Okay. So those seed funds come at those stage, or BIRAC also has different funds for later stage after BIG. So there are options available, and we'll be happy to, you know, tell you which ones are best for you.
Dr. Smita?
Yeah.
Yes.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello, how are you doing?
Yeah, yeah, good, fine, thank you.
Great session, madam, and you really gave us a good 360 degree view of what the Venture Center is doing and the big grant. You always hear the big grant, and we feel it is not an approachable platform for researchers, but I think you made it appear relatively very accessible, and through Venture Center probably where mentoring can be done and the ventures can be set up. Yeah. I had a question for you. Other than this big grant, does Venture Center actually support researchers for writing projects to other funding bodies?
Yes, we do.
Okay.
So as I said, we'll be announcing Ignition program maybe today or on Monday, or I can separately share the details with you. So if you register for that, there is a grant application session there. Or else also you can, you know, come to us and we'll be happy to help you for that. So that is there, yes.
Okay. So other than DBP, for example, DST and other such funding bodies?
Yes, yes. Any of the fundings. For BIRAC also, for academicians, there is PACE.
Okay.
For that also. Or say for students, there is NIDHI EIR, then there is NIDHI PRAYAS. And there are different types of grants from DST as well as DBP for any of those.
Okay, so that is good. One more question. For example, suppose we apply for a big grant and we have an industry partner, in the sense that that industry partner is interested in our product once we are able to establish our technology using the funds generated through the big grant.
Yeah.
So is that possible?
Yes, yes, that's possible. So there is a plan for commercialization section there. Go to market, they'll ask you what is your strategy. So there you can mention that we have decided to work on this technology and develop it up to this stage, and we would be licensing it. So we have already, you know, spoken to some of the technology seekers or some industries who are happy to accept this, and they are willing to accept. They have shown interest, and those talks are in progress or already done, and we would then license it to them. So that actually add credentials to the application, that already someone is there who believes in your idea and is ready to accept it and take it ahead.
Okay.
So that's a good thing.
Okay.
You should mention it.
Okay. And in case we don't have an industry partner, does the Venture Center help us to link to any investors or any that you may be interested in our technology or product?
Yes, yes. We will do that. So as I said, we have a technology transfer office. So the technology transfer office has this particular website where they are right now doing matchmaking of technology providers and technology seekers. So that option is also available. We can connect you if you are willing to license it later. You know, that's possible.
Thank you. we are aware Venture Center has lots of facilities. So suppose we Venture Center has lots of good facilities. So suppose we as an incubator put up our establish our in Venture Center. So does Venture Center allow us to use all other facilities within the campus?
Yes. So as I said, some of the facilities are shared lab facilities.
Okay.
So those you can, you know, as means you can directly walk in and perform the experiments there. And then there are some facilities which are operated by our own skilled persons, because those are very high end, like LC-MS or a DSC. There you will just submit your sample and, you know, it like a service, we will do the analysis and provide the results to you.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Is Venture Center provides support for doing preliminary studies?
Preliminary studies, technical help, little we might help you. And yes, all the facilities and services are there which you can use. But if you are talking about technical mentoring, then we can connect you to some technical mentors. But some initial work has to be done from, you know, at your end.
Thank you. And if you write a proposal for a big, is Venture Center provides guidance about reviewing the proposal and providing some?
Yes. So we do one-on-one mentoring, you know, to sharpen your pitch deck or say modify your proposal in such a way that it has, you know, more chances of getting through. So that happens.
Thank you.
So are we good to close, because we have another meeting and people are waiting here? But my email address is there with you and contact details are there. You can connect anytime over email for any questions which you all have. I'll be happy to share the information.
Sure.